Well, she comes from Hollywood royalty. Now she's following in her dad's footsteps, starring in her first big feature film from 47 meters down, Uncaged. Please welcome Sistine Stallone.
Thank you.
Welcome, welcome. Hi,
good morning.
Good morning.
So, I would imagine you grew up around movie sets.
Yes, okay, my whole life, yeah.
So how different was it for you now being in front of the camera?
Extremely different. I feel like my sisters and I were always behind the scenes, always just running around, causing issues on set for my dad. So it was kind of cool to be the professional one this time.
But you told us off camera that acting wasn't something you even wanted to do.
No, I just wanted to go to school and kind of be normal. That's how my parents raised me. And so I thought, why not do something out of my comfort zone? And the script fell into my lap.
All right, so now why do you say out of your comfort zone?
I hate the sound of my voice on camera, so I'm like, oh God, no, we'll let this one slide. Like, we don't have to do it. And I think having my dad be an actor, it was always around the home, so I thought, I'll do my own path, but it didn't really work out that way. So.
And you're not the only one where you're starring in your first major feature film, because your co-star is Jamie Foxx's daughter.
Yep, Corinne. Yeah, we've actually met before, and she was so lovely, so it was so nice to have kind of a second little sister on set with me.
I love that picture of your dad. We know him as tough guy, and then he's got all these women that are in the house. Three daughters.
Yep. And nothing gets by.
And mom. How was he as a dad? Was he strict? Was he?
Oh, you know, he was strict about certain things. When it came to school, my mom was definitely A-type. Uh-huh. But my dad was, he was strict about curfew.
Yes.
And strict about dating.
Uh-huh. Could you imagine a guy, though, coming to the house and got to meet Sylvester?
Yeah, no, it doesn't happen often.
Yeah, that's stressful.
You're the disease, I'm the cure.
All right, so getting back to 47 meters down Uncaged, it seems like a very rigorous role for you. I mean, there's scuba diving involved.
Yeah.
So did you have to train for this part?
Yeah, none of the girls had training prior to shooting, and I may have fibbed a little bit that I was licensed before shooting. You got to do what you got to do, right? So, the training was intense. We did a week of training in the Dominican Republic.
Wow.
And probably a month of working out before, so yeah.
Wow.
Yep.
Well, let's take a look at a clip.
Everything we need.
I mean, there's no fins, so.
Come on, it's the first cave. We're not swimming the whole city.
Guys, cave diving is dangerous.
Cave diving is dangerous.
No, Mia is right, Nicole. I don't really know about this.
Look, we come all this way and we don't even see the temple. Really?
It's unlike anything you've ever seen before. We should just go in, go once around the first cave, and then out.
Yeah, come on.
When was the last time you went diving?
I mean, years ago. I used to go all the time with Dad, but I had never been in caves before.
It's like riding a bike, right? I mean,
come on, Mia.
Me.
Yeah, she's gonna do it. Let's go. Yeah, let's go.
That cave.
Do it.
Yep.
Bad things happen, huh?
So, Sistine, you were telling me something awfully fascinating about the set for the film.
Yeah. So basically, we shot in London, and they were two ginormous tanks, and essentially they built underwater stages. So every single day, there would be a completely new set of tunnels and caves and turns, and the director would say, okay, girls, go explore, and it was so much fun.
And then the broccoli and the...
Oh, yes, this was traumatic. PTSD for sure, can never eat broccoli again. So to make the water look murky and muggy, essentially, they would blend up broccoli and put it in the water. But this is where it gets interesting. The water was heated, and they'd also put milk in there.
Oh.
And so eventually, we were human soup. It cooked, and we smelled like a crock pot. We love movies.
Yeah, movie magic.
Speaking of loving movies, what's your favorite film of your dad's?
Oh God, I always say Rhinestone, and he hates that. Come on, Dolly Parton. Like, come on.
Yeah.
It doesn't get better.
That's what you'd expect a daughter to say.
I know. Like, gotta give him a hard time.
Here's my dad. I'd be like, Tango and Cash. All right, Sistine, thank you so much for coming
in.
Don't forget, 47 meters down, Uncaged, in theaters now.
Thanks, Sistine. Nice to meet you.